Hey guys, Cal here with a new video on Marvel's Spider-Man 2. Let's dive into some exciting news that leaked last year from the incredible Insomniac Games following one of the biggest hacks in the gaming industry. Apparently they've got a project in the works called Venom Lethal Protector, set in the same universe as Marvel's Spider-Man games. Now, assuming these games share continuity and considering Insomniac's stellar track record, we can expect some awesome trends and features to make their way into Venom Lethal Protector. But before we jump into it, make sure to hit that like button, and if you're not subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Hit that subscribe button for a web swing journey into Marvel Spider-Man 2 updates and all things Marvel gaming. But here's the kicker. Venom's game is likely to play out quite differently from the Spider-Man titles we're used to. You see, while Spidey is all about elegant swings and non-lethal combat, Venom, on the other hand, with his fierce and brutal style, is going to bring a whole new life to traversal combat and mission structure, so you should brace yourself for a different, darker experience. Now let's talk about the traditional Insomniac approach to Spider-Man tutorial missions. If you've played Spider-Man games from Insomniac, you know they kick off with epic showdowns, serving both as a thrilling intros and handy tutorials like the Kingpin boss fight in Spider-Man PS4 or the Sandman boss fight in Marvel's Spider-Man 2. It's a tradition at this point, and we can expect the next Spider-Man game to probably follow suit as well, but I personally think that Venom's games might skip this tradition. Why? Well, Venom's story needs a very different approach. Considering the apparent end of the symbiote in Marvel's Spider-Man 2, the Venom game will have some serious explaining to do, like who's currently the host of the symbiote and how did it survive. Throwing players into a major battle right away simply won't cut it. The game needs to set the stage, right? So what could Venom's game do instead of the typical opening villain fight? Now, picture this. Maybe a slow burn, start with a grounded premise, build up the tension, and let players feel the impending Venom transformation. Then flip the script. Make the player the destructive force. It's a unique opportunity for Insomniac Games to break away from the usual structural conventions and tell Venom's story in a fresh and gripping way. Another way they could set up the Venom game is by the highly rumored Marvel's Spider-Man 2 DLC content, with Carnage being heavily teased in the Flame side mission, and Insomniac probably wanting to finish all symbiote-related storylines before the inevitable Marvel Spider-Man 3 is announced. With it being more of an Otto Octavius and Norman Osborn-centered storyline, further confirmed by the Marvel Spider-Man 2 post-credits scene showing both of these characters interacting with each other and teasing a sort of teaming up against both the Spider-Men. But who knows? Insomniac could totally go the normal approach and use Carnage in Marvel's Spider-Man 3, but I do firmly believe that Carnage will be featured in a DLC content for Marvel's Spider-Man 2, but I don't know. I would love to know your thoughts in the comment section regarding the same. The Venom Lethal Protector game has its work cut out, establishing the host's identity, background, and transformation into Venom. Whether it's Eddie Brock or another character, Insomniac has to craft an engaging narrative. So, waving goodbye to the style of opening missions we've seen in the Spider-Man games might be a smart move for the Venom game. Exciting times ahead, folks. Stay tuned for more updates on the symbiotic adventure. And that is it for this video, guys. Are you excited about the Venom game by Insomniac? Or is there something you would like to see happen in the game? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section and like, share, and subscribe to the channel for more content ahead. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.